is dura. In fact, here is the dura. It's broke here, but it splits in two. So in between, you have a dural sinus. So this is where we would have venous blood. Then the arachnoid is very thin. It's kind of a little dark line you see, you may or may not see here. And that's not really the takeaway. The takeaway is this is the subarachnoid space that the arrow is in. So again, let me repeat this. This is the dural sinus between the endosteal and the meningeal dura that houses venous blood. This is the subarachnoid space that houses the CSF. Then you can see this little dark sliver of a line here, and that's the pia. Now when we're dissecting those sheep brains, remind me to show you the pia. You can do it yourself. You take a tweezers and you just kind of just literally tweeze off the surface, the shiny little surface. And you'll see that. So now if we look here, this is the takeaway. All of this right here are millions upon millions upon millions of pyramidal cells. The cerebral cortex, beginning in the, it always begins and ends with pyramidal cells. And you may say, what the heck is that? Well, these are multipolar neurons. If you initiate any type of voluntary movement, that initiation is triggered by multipolar neurons. If sensory information is coming in, you're making sense of it, you're consciously aware of it, that sensation is interpreted by multipolar neurons. They're also known as pyramidal cells. And pyramidal refers to pyramidal. Pyramidal refers to triangular. And here's a few, look at all these guys right here. So, see these? Boop, 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 boop. All of these are pyramidal cells. Now I'm going to bump up even further. And the cerebral cortex is basically packed with these suckers. Now, I'm assuming this is the axon, but I'm not going to ask you that. Again, you need to identify these as specifically as pyramidal cells. They are multipolar neurons. And then you see all these other surface structures here, right here, the circular structures. They're more round. Okay? Those are nuclei of neuroglia. Remember, we just don't have neurons, we have neuroglia in the central nervous system. Astrocytes, oligodendrocytes, microglia, and if it's lining, then ventricles, ependymal cell. Well, this is no ventricles here, so they're not ependymal cells. And then you see all this, you know, this little tiny fine little, what are those? Dendrites. And perhaps axons in there as well. Okay, so we just have a tremendous amount of these. You can see this pyramidal cell here. That's probably the axon going, this direction. And then you see all those kind of little dendrites, and they get so fine that it just looks like this jumbled mess you're seeing. Real simple. Okay. Does anybody have any questions on the cerebral cortex before we continue? Alrighty then. The next slide contains two structures we're going to be, you guys want to know about. Recognize what the heck this structure is here?
Cerebellum.
Well, it is part of the brain.
Cerebellum.
Cerebellum. You guys remember this image? See this? See how these were? Kind of Well, that cerebellum is this. Everybody with me? Okay. Now, the cerebellum, you see these dark cells, all these little dark dots, these are made up of what's known as granular cells, and then bordering on the granular cells are cells known as Purkinje cells. And I want to show you an image of that. So this is the cerebellar cortex. This is what we were just looking at. And then you have this area that's dark, dotted dark, and there are a bunch of granular cells. And what we're focusing on, whoops, are these guys. Everybody see these guys here? These are called Purkinje cells. And this, the Purkinje cells are unique in the fact that their dendritic extensions are just are incredibly densely packed. These guys can make upwards of 200,000 synapses with other cells. You know, think about that. There are tens of millions of these Purkinje cells that each one of them make upwards of 200,000 synapses. So what's 30 million times 200,000? I mean, it's just a mind-boggling number, right? It's just a googly-googly-plex number, where you have to appreciate, you know, these synapses between these cells and the firing back and forth of these is actually what's coordinating me walking around smoothly right now, and me signing my signature consistently every single time. It looks the same. It looks the same. This is what is producing what we call this muscle memory. So let's go ahead and take a look at these Purkinje cells here and their dendrites. And for that, I need to go back to this. I'm going to crank up my magnification. And here we see, lined up right here, here. Everybody see this line of cells? These are granular cells. We're not concentrating on those. We're concentrating on the Purkinje cells. I'm gonna jump up even further back. Move it down so I can reach it. And then you can see here that the Purkinje cells, and this is harder to see because the dendrites are so fine that they basically go into this direction. Now these are other cells, including neuroglia, so we're not concentrating on these, we're concentrating specifically on these Purkinje cells. And again, you can't see the dendrites, but all of this gobbledygook that you're seeing here is dendritic extensions. So we have this intermingling of all of these dendrites from all of these different cells that are engulfing this particular area. And that, those Purkinje cells specifically are the ones that you want to pay attention to.
So those big ones that just meet the line of
the Yeah, they're large, they're really, really big cells relative to the other neurons, right? Again, they're huge, the cell lines are huge because they have all these dendrites as well.
So those cells that are on this side?
These are granular cells.
Yeah.
Don't worry about those. But bordering on those granular cells are the Purkinje cells, and the dendritic extensions are going in this direction. All of this pinkish stuff are dendrites. Okay? Just, you know, engulfed with this very dense pack of dendritic extensions. Okay, so we're gonna move. This is an entire brain. It's probably like a mouse brain or something. So we're going to go from there, and I'm going to go from, you know, this is the back of the head, right? I'm going to travel towards, go through portions of the head, and this is the front. So this is the cerebral cortex in the front. It's kind of messed up from cutting up the slide. But you guys see this here? That structure right there that looks like a jelly roll? Or a seahorse? Probably looks pathetic neuroanatomist, I'd call it a seahorse, right? What is this?
The hippocampus.
So here we can see, I told you hippocampus is more of a conceptual structure. Here, you know, you can't really see it. If you take a slice of the brain, you can't see it. However, you can see the cells involved with that. These are the cells we have here. I'm not going to get into the detail of these cells. You guys just need to recognize this as the hippocampus, and you need to know its function is basically involved with this, you know, short-term, converting short-term, storing short-term, and then converting that into long-term memory. How easy is that? That's it. Stop recording.